Hey everyone, and thanks for joining my YouTube channel. Today I wanted to show you how to download an SVG file off an SVG site, how to extract the file, and how to get it into Silhouette Studio. Side note, this does require a Designer Edition or above version of Silhouette Studio. This will not work with the basic free version that you get from Silhouette. You do need to purchase an upgrade to be able to use SVG files. With that said, roll the intro. Hey, thanks for coming back to my YouTube channel. Today I wanted to show you how to download a file that you get off an SVG site and how to get it into Silhouette Studio. I see a lot of people asking how to do this after they've downloaded files somewhere other than Silhouette Studio, and I wanted to show you how to do it. It's actually a really easy process, so let's get started. The first thing that you're going to need to do is go to an SVG site. So today I'm going to be using Simply Crafty SVGs, and I'm actually going to be downloading a free file from them. I will be putting all the links in the descriptions of all the files that I use. One of the things that you need to know, and hopefully you know, is where, when you do download something, where does your download go? So I'm going to show you that too. So today I am using Chrome, and I am in Windows 10. I can't tell you how this would work in other browsers or other versions of Windows, but this is what I'm using. I really enjoy Chrome, so if you don't use it, give it a try. All right, so let's see where my downloads go. So in order to do that, I have Chrome open, and over in the top right, there's these little three dots, and I'm gonna go ahead and click it, and I'm gonna scroll down to Settings. It's the third one from the bottom. Now I'm gonna scroll all the way down to the bottom and click on Advanced. And then under Downloads, it has my location. So normally I download in a directory called Downloads. But I'm going to change that just for the sake of this video, and I am going to put this on my desktop just so it's easier for us to find for this tutorial. Okay. So now it shows the desktop. And I've also checked ask where to save each file before downloading, and we'll get back to this in a second as well. But you can also set this up to ask you each time where you'd like it saved, which might be a little bit easier because then you can save it in different places depending on what type of file it is. So if you're really organized and you're downloading SVG files, you can download them into certain directories based on either the theme or the holiday or the company that you bought them from. All right, so we've gotten this set up. So now let's go back over to this tab, and I am going to purchase this file. Now that I've actually purchased the file, I'm gonna go ahead and click on the download link and download the file. And as you can see, it's going to download it to my desktop, and it's asking me to confirm that because when we were in the settings screen just a little bit earlier, we told Chrome to ask us where we'd like it to be saved. So even though I set it to save to desktop and it defaulted to desktop, it's still going to ask me, are you sure that's where you want to save it? So I'm going to go ahead and click save, and it's downloading. Now, one of the cool things about Chrome is, I'll show you. So you see it says open, always open files of this type and show in folder. Now, if I click always open files of this type, anytime I download a zip file, it's gonna already pop up on my screen, so I don't have to go look for it next time, and I'll show you that now. So let's go back and get another free file. I am going to get this one. So now when I download this one, you'll see what happens. So now that I've set the Chrome up to always open this file type, it's already going to bring me this window. Now this just saves us a step. If you don't want to do that, that's fine. But pretty much all I have to do is extract all, and I will extract the zip file. Now, if you're not sure what a zip file is, it's a file that consists of multiple other files. So for example, I like to use the terminology envelope. So if you're mailing a letter to somebody, you put the letter in an envelope with additional contents if necessary. Well, when you receive the letter, you open it. To me, this is the same thing, because you put it in an envelope to save space and it's compact and convenient. Pretty much the same thing with a download file. Plus you have an addition is that it compresses the file. So it does compact it all together into one file, but it does compress it as well to make the file size smaller. So now all I have to do is extract all. So from here, all I have to do is hit extract all and it'll extract it. But I'm also going to show you what the original file that I downloaded that went to my desktop. There's two different ways now I can do it. So if I hit extract all, I'm going to hit browse, and I'm going to put this where I put all my SVG files. And I have a directory for SVG files. So I'm going to, now that I'm in the directory for Simply Crafty SVGs, this is a directory that I had prior on my my hard drive. I'm going to add a new folder because I like to keep everything organized, and this is an oval swing card. I'm going to hit select folder. And then extract. So it doesn't look like much has changed, but if you can see from the window below it, this is showing oval.zip and it has extract all in it, but the new window that popped up has the oval swing card and it has my files in there. So if I double click on here, it has my SVG files. So that's, now it's extracted. Now, if you do it from the desktop, it's pretty similar. So I'm gonna pull the Boo Halloween card. As you can see, it is zipped. I'm gonna right click it, extract all, same window, browse. It defaulted back to the last directory I was at. So let's go back to Simply Crafty SVGs. And I'm going to name this Boo Halloween card. So I'm going to do a new folder, Boo Halloween card, select folder. Sometimes you got to hit it twice, select folder. And now I make sure that this is checked to show extracted files when complete, because that'll bring up that second window, extract. So there's my files. So now I can go ahead and jump into Silhouette Studio and open those. So I'm going to do File, Open, and I'm going to locate the files that I just downloaded. or just extractive, I am sorry. And those are in my this directory here. So Boo Halloween card, SVG files, and then here's all my SVG files. So card one, open. And now let's turn on the cut lines. Go to the send menu in the top right. Make sure your design is highlighted. And click the cut button. This is the most important step. When you import an SVG into Silhouette Designer Edition, the cut lines are defaulted to no cut. So it is important that you go and turn the cut lines on. And when you're finished, then you can go ahead and hit the send button and get your project cut out. Thanks for joining me. I hope you learned something today. If you could please rate, comment, and subscribe, it would help YouTube show my video to more people. Thanks and have a great day.